100 years from now, I think we'll be celebrating the centennial of 2020 and all the stuff that's going to happen in 2020. Not just this crazy pandemic and all the stuff is happening, but this, as far as space goes, 2020 is going to be a really good year. I know 2020, I'll admit, 2020 so far has not been one of my more favorite years. In fact, it's pretty terrible, all right? It's been pretty awful. But I can also tell you that there's going to be something really, really amazing that happens in 2020, which is that we're finally going to see their true launch, no pun intended, of this whole new era of space exploration, led by a lot of private companies working in partnership with NASA that are going to take us back to space using American rockets launching from American soil. And it's going to happen first by SpaceX. And SpaceX is we've been working on the Crew Dragon vehicle for a long time now, and this is the year it's going to fly. You know, we have a date actually scheduled, let's see, only 2 months from now is when we plan to do the first flight with people, and it's going to be Bob Behnken, Doug Hurley, two former colleagues of mine, two friends of mine, are going to be the first test pilots to fly Dragon up to the space station. And so we're finally going to get to the point in SpaceX where we're launching people on our rockets, which is what the company was founded for. But it's not just SpaceX. It's also Boeing is not that far behind on their spacecraft, the Starliner. And then we have two other private companies that are doing suborbital flights purely for space tourism. But they also, both these companies, have plans and ambitions to go beyond that. And that is a Blue Origin that has a new Shepard vehicle that's going to go straight up, like I was saying before, it's going to go straight up and straight back down, but you'll get high enough to see the curvature of the Earth. You'll experience about 5 minutes of floating in zero gravity. And look, it's going to be an incredible ride. If I hadn't already gone myself, I would totally be buying a ticket right now. And so Elon, Jeff Bezos, they put a lot of their effort and money and resources into kind of jump-starting this whole, get us back on that trajectory to where we're headed towards having a colony on Mars, or in the case of Jeff Bezos, he wants to have massive space stations where millions of people can live in space and do all the manufacturing. He wants to basically turn Earth into a national park kind of thing where you can come and visit, but let's get all the factories off of this planet so we stop polluting it. So they have these incredibly grand visions. So that's going to change everything. The access to space for humans is going to drastically expand this year in 2020. So I think in 100 years, first of all, we're going to be celebrating 2020. So 2120, get ready for a big party, I would say. Just like we had all these great events to celebrate the 50th anniversary of landing on the moon, Apollo 11 and the Apollo program, we're going to be celebrating 2020, I think, in the same way, because this is just the start. All those things I just described, as wonderful as they are and as big of a step as they are, it's just the first step. It's because all these companies and all these projects that we're talking about is just the beginning. The next step and the things that they have on the drawing boards, the things not just on the drawing boards, but the things that are being tested in Boca Chica and in other places where the other companies have their test sites, are really going to knock your socks off. We're talking about incredible new machines, new rockets that can carry lots of people and go much further back to the moon, onto Mars, but what's happening here in 2020 is the start of all that. Basically, all those dreams that we were promised in science fiction in the 1950s about like taking your vacations amongst the rings of Saturn and all that, that's starting now, and we're heading that way. And I couldn't be more excited about that.
Get smarter faster with new videos daily at 5 a.m. Eastern.